Myanmar men who murdered UK backpackers on Ko Tao have their death sentences commuted to life. Confusion developed over the weekend when some media reported that both Zorlin and Y Phyo had been pardoned. This drew a clarification from a lawyer acting on their behalf explaining that their death sentence had simply been commuted. The two men will now serve life sentences in prison but may be eligible for further sentence reductions in the future. A comment by the brother of one of the two Myanmar men who had their death sentences commuted to life imprisonment through a royal decree issued by the Thai king on Friday, may have given rise to some media reports that the pair were pardoned. The two men, along with all those on Bangkok prison's death row, including a former MP, have their death sentences instead commuted to life imprisonment. A lawyer for both Myanmar men, Zorlin and Y Phyo, issued a statement over the weekend that pointed out that both men had not been pardoned and instead had received clemency from the Thai king through a royal decree which commuted their death sentences to life imprisonment for the murders in 2014 of UK backpackers, Hannah Witheridge and David Miller, inset left. A lawyer for the two men who last week had their death sentences commuted to life imprisonment through the clemency of the Thai king, have issued statements to clarify that Zorlin and Y Phyo had, contrary to some media reports that the pair received a pardon, their sentences commuted. The lawyer pointed out that this would have required his clients to admit to their guilt for the crime that they were convicted of by a court sitting on Koh Samui on Christmas Eve 2015. To clear up any misunderstanding, this is what has been requested in the appeal letter to the King of Thailand. Some people have been under the impression that a pardon has been sought, which would require the convicted to admit their guilt. This is not the case. In the appeal letter, we requested that the death sentence be commuted, as the two are young and supporting their widowed mothers, said lawyer Yuong Myofant, who was appointed to assist the pair by the Myanmar Embassy in Bangkok. Brings an end to the case following the murders in September 2014 which shocked the world. This brings an end to the legal process in a case that began in September 2014 on the idyllic island of Koh Tao when two young British tourists were attacked and beaten to death in a secluded spot on the island. 23-year-old Hannah Witheridge, who attended the University of Essex in Norfolk in the UK, and 24-year-old David Miller from Jersey, were beaten to death by a blunt instrument near the seashore of the island. The incident provoked a massive police investigation which led police to the two Myanmar men, both low-paid migrants who were working on the island. The murders generated a frenzy of media coverage amplified by the exotic nature of the location and the youthful good looks of the victims, both with their lives ahead of them. Debate over the guilt or innocence of the pair. There has been some debate, over the years, as to the guilt of the pair. The conviction continues to be a source of controversy and when first announced, generated riots in Myanmar and even some protest activity in Thailand itself. Critics of the case against the men have argued that, as impoverished migrant laborers from Myanmar's Rakhine state, the two were scapegoats identified by investigating police officers as international coverage and interest in the case mounted. Nonetheless, the family of David Miller, who observed and sat through the trial in 2015 on Koh Samui, were entirely satisfied as to their guilt in the murders which included the rape of Ms. Witheridge. However, they have always called on Thai officials to show leniency to the men and not to carry out the death sentence. They were being held on Thailand's death row. Both Zorlin and Y Phyo have been held since their conviction in Thailand's notorious Bangkok prison in Nonthaburi province where the kingdom's last execution, by lethal injection, was carried out in June 2018. The decree followed the monarch's birthday on 28 July and has also been extended to other high-profile individuals serving long prison sentences including former ministers as an act of clemency. Among those benefiting from the move is former Phu Thai MP, Nor Attocharonsuk, sentenced to death last year for the murder of an official in Konkain who he suspected of having an affair with his wife. The Myanmar pair may now also be eligible, with good behavior, to future sentence reductions and with their young age, may at some point, hope to be released. Convictions and death sentences were upheld by Thai courts on appeal in 2017 and 2019. The convictions and sentences imposed on the two men were upheld by the Thai Court of Appeal in 2017 and later by the Supreme Court in 2019, which reaffirmed the death sentence for the pair. Another lawyer for the two men on Friday, Nadthasiri Bergman, said that the decree commuting their sentences applied to all inmates being held at Bangkok on death row and was effective immediately. brother may have sparked the mix-up. A brother of Win Zoltun, Yi Zoltun, may have contributed to the confusion when he joyfully welcomed a development by mistakenly referring to it as a pardon for his brother. Speaking with the AFP news agency, he said, "I can't find words to express how thankful we are. We knew this case was totally unfair, and we sometimes feel bitterness, but we want to say thanks for the royal pardon."